Hey there, Jeremy Weiss here with Weiss Tech Hockey and HockeyShot.com. In this video, I want to introduce you to a skating maneuver called the Inside Mohawk. Now, the Inside Mohawk is a very versatile maneuver that you'll be able to use in a lot of different instances on the ice in game situations. We'll show you some of those, some of the ways that you can use this move later on in this video. But believe it or not, this is actually a fairly new skating maneuver. It hasn't been very popular until really quite recently. Sidney Crosby is one of the ones in the NHL that really uses this move a lot, and I think that's part of the reason why other players have started noticing and started using the Inside Mohawk as well. When I was a kid, almost no coaches even knew about the Mohawk. Very few coaches taught it, and very few players used it. We had a skills instructor by the name of Dan Cameron, fantastic coach, really good guy, and he actually taught my team to use the Mohawk back when I was probably, I would say, 10 or 11 years old, so it was quite a few years ago. But it's been really interesting to watch the game and the pace of the game and watch players gradually begin to implement this skating maneuver in today's game, and to see how far ahead of the curve Dan Cameron was when he taught it to our team and the other teams that he was working with. Back in the early 90s, or maybe late 80s, it would have been early 90s. So anyways, that's probably enough for the intro. Let's clip over. I want to show you how to do this, show you what the move is, and then we'll go to some instances of how you can use this, a little bit of how you can practice this. We're doing all the demos today on the HockeyShot synthetic ice panels. So we've got these laid down in the basement. It makes for a fantastic surface, really slick, and you can skate on them. So it lets us do a lot of different stuff right here in the basement. So let's go ahead and show you what this move is all about. Okay, so first and foremost, what is the Mohawk? You've noticed I've pulled the camera way back so we can kind of get the whole thing in the frame, hopefully, and be able to show you what we've got as far as what the Mohawk is. The Mohawk is a turn where basically you've got both of your heels together and you're on both inside edges at the same time. So that's why I call it the Inside Mohawk, because you're on both inside edges at the same time. So it looks kind of like this. Now there's a number of different ways you can use this, and like I said, we'll kind of go through some of these as we go, but the turn itself looks like this. Okay, so that's obviously, that's going the one way. The other way would look like this. Okay, so you can see what we're doing is we're gliding on both inside edges at the same time. Now, the turn itself, you can use this in a ton of different ways. You can use this if you're coming in and you're on your off wing and you know that the pass is going to be coming. So instead of trying to do a shovel a one-timer on your backhand at the net, you can open up into that Mohawk and use your forehand to let that shot go. You see it used like that. I use it like that quite often. You can use it to slip check. So say you're up against the boards, defenseman's coming in, you can combine it with a toe drag, slip the check, defenseman goes skating by, and now you're on your way. We use these as defensemen a ton. So especially going backwards pivot, when you're going skating backwards and you need to open up and skate forward. So for example, like on a regroup, where you're backing up, bringing the puck back, you open up and turn. And that's how you open up. So we're going from backwards to forwards. I'll try that one more time. We'll go backwards, open to go forward, and now we're up ice. So hopefully you can see how that could work. What else? We've got instances where you're coming in. You can actually combine the Inside Mohawk with a toe drag as you're shooting on the goalie. And as you pull in that toe drag and open him up, then it opens him up to go five hole. So I've seen that done. We can, like I said, there's a lot of different ways to use this. As you get good at it, you'll find yourself using it over and over and over, sometimes without even realizing you're doing it. Now, to be able to actually perform this turn or this pivot and make it work for you in games, there's a few key points. I usually like to try to break the skills down into three main points, and then from there, you can get your players established on those three key points, and then, fine-tune the details afterwards. So, first and foremost, anytime we're talking almost any skill in hockey, step one is going to be you got to get a deep knee bend. Without the deep knee bend, none of this is going to be possible. In fact, even just try it. Try standing up straight-legged and open your toes as wide as possible. You're not going to get, if you're really flexible, you might get a little bit more than a 90-degree angle, but for me, no way. It's unless I get a deep knee bend, there's no way I'm getting my skates parallel with each other, right? So that's the first key point. Bend your knees. Second, get your heels together, right? And then the third is you're actually, there's a little bit of a weight transfer involved with this. So especially if you're using this to maintain a turn or to increase speed, and I'll show you that in a second, to increase speed as you're in the Mohawk, you're going to need to be a weight transfer. So front to back, front to back. And that's how you're going to be able to make this work for you in the games. What I recommend doing is nail down the turn itself first. There's a number of drills that work on this. One of the easiest ones is the square drill, Mohawk square drill, and I'll put a link to that in the description of this video. But basically, you're just going to set up cones. You're going to go around each cone in a square, doing a Mohawk around each cone. So basically, it's just, you know, easy pivot, Mohawk, turn around each cone, and then from there, get back in the line. Get used to going both ways. It's very common to have one side that's stronger than the other for players, so don't get discouraged if one side's a lot easier than the other, but you need to get good at doing it both ways. Once you're proficient at this, then it gets really fun, because then you can start, like I said, maintaining the Mohawk in stride, so you can actually get going. And this is where you'll see Sidney Crosby use this a ton, is he'll get going, he's driving wide down the boards, and the defenseman takes his angle or whatever, so instead of stopping, he keeps his momentum going, but now as he's going behind the net, he's opening up into that Mohawk, so he can still keep his upper body facing the middle of the ice, so that anytime there's a receiver open, now he can make that pass, and he's constantly got his eyes on the middle of the play, instead of having to turn his back to the play. So I'm going to show you what that looks like a little bit, where we can keep the Mohawk going. I'll try to get a few different camera angles so we can hopefully get a good picture of what this actually looks like. But it'll look something like this. So that's your inside Mohawk. Once again, fantastic maneuver, very versatile, lots of different ways you can use this on the ice, and you'll find yourself using it, once you get good at it, you'll find yourself using it in game situations without even realizing that you're doing it. Once again, you can pick up these synthetic ice panels along with all your other hockey training aids at HockeyShot.com. And also make sure to visit us at WeistechHockey.com for more drills, skills, tips, and other videos that will help you to improve your game.